Hello everyone, I am Anika Prashad. I study in class 3A in East Point School. Today I am going to tell you a story. Its name is The Dancing Shoe. Once upon a time, there lived a girl named Karen. She lived in the country and her family was very rich. Karen's mother fed her with tasty food and dressed her in pretty clothes and shoes. Karen was a healthy girl, her face glowed and she was beautiful. However, she was also very proud of her looks. She didn't respect her parents and behaved weirdly with all others. Vanity had gotten into her head. One day, as Karen was walking in the forest, she saw a pair of shiny new shoes lying behind the bush. She cried it, "Oh, what a lovely shoes! They must be made for a lovely girl like me." And put on the shoes. But just as she out on the shoes, her feet began tapping. Soon she was dancing and couldn't stop. She danced from the forest to the village and then to the town. But alas, no one could help her. Night fell and Karen was still dancing. By now, she was back in the forest and was very tired. Suddenly, she saw a silver angel right in front of her. The angel held her sword and said, "You have been punished because of your pride and vanity, Karen. You must mend your ways." She vanished. Karen was very sad after this. Trying bitterly, Karen found a woodcutter's axe and cut her feet with it. She wept, "I lost my feet because of my vanity." That day onwards, Karen began living in the forest. She was kind to the animals and lived on berries and other fruits of the jungle. One day, the angel appeared before her again. This time, she was holding a wreath of roses instead of the sword. The angel said, "You have mended your ways, dear Karen. You shall not suffer anymore." And she gave her the wreath of roses. The moment Karen held it in her hands, colorful petals flew around her. There was a flash of golden light and she got back her feet. She rushed home happily and hugged her parents. Thereafter, Karen spent the rest of her life with a better behavior, treating everyone with kindness and generosity. Moral: we must not let pride overtake us. Thank you.